Sometimes we forget that God has put us here. And he put us in this place because he knew every one of us were long shots.
We are pressed on every side by troubles. But we are not crushed. We are perplexed, but not driven to despair. We are hunted down, but never abandoned by God. We get knocked down, but we are not destroyed. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I was a long shot, but I won with God. I was a long shot, but I won with God. Tell somebody, say, come on, say, neighbor, me, say, me. I was a long shot, but I won with God. That's what we're going to talk about. I was a long shot, but I won with God. Ain't that good news just to know you was a long shot, but you won with God? I know it's not no long shots in the house, so it's okay. But let me tell you something. I was a long shot, and I ain't ashamed to say it. I won with God. I was a long shot. As Christians, we sometimes forget there is no place for defeat in God's plan. Thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. And whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world, and this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. In Jesus, we shall triumph over every foe. We shall overcome every malady. We shall overcome every pain and every sorrow. Because God is going to win, and we who enlist in his army are going to win because we are his and he is ours. Therefore, as Christians, we need to keep this in mind as we navigate the tumultuous seas of life and find ourselves in the throes of despair, feeling as though we are fighting an uphill battle with no end in sight. In these moments of darkness, we need to reflect on the divine intervention that permeates our existence, guiding us toward the light at the end of the tunnel. This divine intervention is not fleeting occurrences, but a constant beacon of hope that illuminates our path even in the darkest nights. Defying the odds begins with the belief that, first of all, you ain't average. It requires knowing that you are above average in your natural abilities and in the amount of grit and hard work you are willing to apply to developing the things that lead you to believe in the possibilities. Defying the odds requires trusting and believing that God is in control despite of our circumstances. Fighting against the odds is not an easy task, but it's a noble one. It is a chance to prove your worth and to show the world that you are capable. Sometimes we got to understand what it means to be a long shot. people done said, you ain't gonna make it. It can't be done. You ain't the one. But can I tell you something? I like being a long shot. Because the scripture says, if God be for you, who in the world can possibly be against you? Sometimes we forget that God has put us here. And he put us in this place because he knew every one of us were long shots. God allowed us to go through what we went through because God knew, first of all, we had some peculiar ways. And the scripture in fact says we are a peculiar people. And by us being a peculiar people, we don't easily fit in where we can get in. And since we don't fit in where we can get in, that makes us long shots, because people who don't fit in where they can get in ain't gonna get in. But when you got God on your side, you're gonna win even as a long shot. See, defying the odds is a personal thing. And it was stated that the famous and renowned poet Robert Browning had mismatched eyes. One eye was focused on a short view. And that's what we customarily speak of as nearsightedness. And the other eye was focused on a long view. And that's what we generally speak of as being farsighted. Browning instead of letting what proved to be a handicap hold him back, he turned what was an apparent disadvantage and handicap into an advantage that helped him rather than hindered him. And his testimony, I believe, if he was here today, would be, I was a long shot, but with God, I won. See, sometimes we allow our handicaps to hold us back. But everybody got a handicap. Go ahead and tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, everybody got a handicap. Everybody got a handicap. And it ain't no super blank rolls. Everybody got a handicap. When you play golf, they give you a handicap because they know you ain't good as the rest of them. When you play senior softball, they give you a handicap. They tell you if you get to the base, you can get somebody to run the rest of the way if you can't make it. Y'all don't want to hear what I'm saying. Everybody got a handicap. But you cannot allow that handicap to hold you back. Now, we may not and cannot always understand God's way and his ways, because he puts weights on us and gives us burdens we can't lift. He gives us crosses we can't carry. He gives us hardships too awesome for us to handle. And he gives us tribulations we must endure. See, God does what he has to do to keep you on the long shot team. See, Payne has a way of causing us to forget that God is faithful. And if you're going through a job loss today, I want you to know I've been laid off before. If you're going through financial troubles today, I want you to know that there was a time in my walk with God where I literally had nothing. But I trusted God. If you have lost a loved one, I want you to know that I've lost a loved one. And if you've been disappointed, I want you to know I've been disappointed too. If you're going through situations where your name is being or is being slandered. I want you to know I've been there too. I'm probably there right now. You know, but God has been faithful in one situation after another, and there's never been a time that God did not provide. Sometimes you got to look at what you're going through and see how God is using that what you're going through to make you stronger. Is there anybody here who's not too ashamed just to make the devil mad just for a minute and tell the story that something that you went through made you stronger, where the next time you saw it, you were able to face it head on and it did not even faze you because you flipped it off because you said, if it had not been for the Lord on my side. See, you got to learn from what you go through. You can't lay hands on everybody, but you can pray on everybody. Oh Lord, help me somebody. See, somebody took that wrong when I said pray. That said they took it to the P-R-E-Y. No, I'm talking about the P-R-A-Y. When you learn how to P-R-A-Y on everybody, you don't have to worry about what the end gonna be. Because God done told you what it means when it says they that wait upon the Lord shall experience a renewal of their strength. I've learned through my trials and faith in God, there's no place for defeat in God's plan. The cross cannot be defeated, for it is defeat. And when we keep the faith, we can see where God has added the pluses even when the minuses have been dominating your life. Y'all will catch that on the way home. See, when you look back over your own life, when you let Jesus in, that was the plus. And regardless of how many minuses you had, y'all know what minuses is, don't you? For the haves and the have-nots, you know, always had, but you had not. But look at what God has done for you right now. See, when you let the Lord come into your life, that was a plus. And it didn't matter how many minuses was in line, and God was still there. And when we keep the faith, we can see where God has added pluses, even where the minuses kept on coming and coming. What is your story? How do you propose to get through what you are going through? For when the odds are stacked against you and you're seemingly outmatched by defeat, my suggestion is to have faith, be patient, and remember how you made it in the past, and say, self, then, just like right now, I was a long shot, but with God, I won. You got to speak to yourself and say, I was a long shot, but I won, Reverend Henry, when I let God come into my life. Now, the author of this text is unquestionably the Apostle Paul. And it's more characteristic of his style and manner than any of his other epistles. It was written during a period of greatly improved relations between Paul and the Corinthian church. In the preceding period, there had been serious differences that endangered Paul's leadership at Corinth. And now, with threatened rebellion no longer troubling Paul to the extent that he was troubled at the height of crisis, Paul wrote, communicating to them his thankful sigh of relief. Moreover, he wrote concerning the offering he expected to gather for the church in Jerusalem. Now, Paul, the great apostle of the Gentiles, whose original name was Saul, he was a native of the city of Tarsus. Paul, his name was Saul, had a Damascus road experience. He was on his way to Jerusalem to wreak havoc in the church
And he was knocked down by a glaring light, and the questioners asked, why are you persecuted down me? The Bible tells us that he was blinded. And when he got up off the ground, he opened his eyes and he couldn't see. The Bible tells us he had to be led blindly to the house of Judas on Straight Street. And the Lord sent a text to Pastor Ananias and said, Pastor, there's somebody at the church who needs you. Ananias parenthetically speaks, said, Lord, why you think I'm at home today? It's because I knew he was coming. Lord said, Ananias, I told you, you got to preach in season and out of season. Ananias went to the Lord's house, and sure enough, Saul was there blind. The Bible says that when he prayed and laid hands on him, he prayed in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And the Bible says that the scales were removed from his eyes. It was at that time his name was changed from Saul to Paul, the great apostle of the Gentiles. Paul wrote 14 of the 27 books in the New Testament, if you count the book of Hebrews. Paul had strict religious training and education, finishing under the great philosopher Gamaliel. Paul, the heart-stirring preacher, missionary, and church leader and builder, was little in stature, bow-legged, cross-eyed with a hooked nose. But he believed that it's only what you do for Christ that will last. This epistle was written on Paul's third missionary journey, probably from Philippi. And Paul, concerned about the presence of false teachers in the church, claiming to be apostles who had entered the church. Therefore, he wrote to defend the authenticity of both his apostleship and the message that he preached. And to tell the Corinthians that struggles will come. But if you keep the faith, your testimony will again be, I was a long shot, but I won with God. Tell you, say, neighbor, I was a long shot, but I won with God. Boy, that, listen, don't that ring a bell in your life? I was a long shot, but I won with God. Now, in our text, Paul speaks to us about facing adversity and finding hope and the fulfillment that comes through divine intervention, reminding us that one day we are all going to be hard pressed on every side, but not crushed. We're going to be perplexed, but not in despair. We're going to be persecuted, but not abandoned. We're going to be struck down, but not destroyed. Because we always carry around in our body the death of Jesus Christ, so that the life of Jesus may also be revealed in our bodies. When we walk, we let people know, as for God I live, and it's for God I must die. And we declare, blessed be the name of the Lord. Now, the Apostle Paul was no stranger, first of all, to set the tone. He was no stranger to adversity. He had faced numerous trials and tribulations, from persecution to imprisonment. Yet, despite these challenges, he remained steadfast in his faith and trusted in God's plan, even when the plan before him seemed impossible to navigate. Paul was one of them brothers who came to the realization that if I trust God, God know more than I know. And if God knows what I'm going through, God ain't gonna allow what I'm going through to consume me. Has anybody here been through something that you knew you was going through it, and while you was going through it, you found yourself talking to God about it and saying, now God, you know it's me. You know what I'm dealing with. Have you ever noticed how the Lord will speak to you in a still small voice and say, I got you? See, when God speaks to you with that still small voice to say, I got you, that's when there's no weapon formed against you. Oh, y'all better hear what I'm saying. Because all things work together for the good of those who love the Lord, who've been called according to his purpose. See, when the devil
back is stacked against you, that's when you know that you're a long shot. And all you can do is just pray, say, now God is in your hands. And see, Paul, in this letter to the Corinthians, he speaks of being hard pressed on every side, yet not crushed, perplexed, but in despair. He said, I've been persecuted, but I ain't been abandoned. I've been struck down. They hit me, but they couldn't knock me out. I ain't destroyed. Ah, y'all better hear what he said. He said, some of the stuff I went through knocked me off my feet. Anybody here ever been through some stuff that knocked them off their feet? And when you got down, you're down. They thought you, notice what I said. They thought you was down for the count, but you snapped back up and began to float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. Then they found out that it was the God in you that had lifted you up off the canvas of life to allow you to show them that I serve a risen Savior. And Paul, he was saying, listen, my brothers and my sisters, don't y'all misunderstand what I'm trying to tell you. This is a testament of unshakable faith. He faced the improbable things of life. The seemingly impossible storms came his way. But with an unwavering faith in God, the storms might have raged in his life, but he was not destroyed by the storms. And Paul was saying, listen, my brothers and my sisters, you're going to have some situations that come your way. Paul's faith was not a passive acceptance of his circumstances. It was instead an active dynamic force that propelled him forward. He didn't just endure his trials, but he used them as a platform to spread the message of Christ's love and salvation. You can't allow when you get knocked down to cause you to quit telling your story. The worst thing in the world for an adversary is when they knock you down and you keep on talking lip. Y'all will catch that after a while. See, your adversary think when they lay hands on you that they done knock you down, that you ain't gonna do it no more. But I'll stand before you to tell you like this: eyes have not seen and ears have not heard the wonders that God has in store for those who love the Lord, who walk not by sight, but walk by faith, leaning and depending on God's everlasting arms. You can't let what you're going through today define what's going to happen tomorrow, but you got to tell your story. I come this far by faith. I ask it of God. God gave it to me. And if God gave it to me, it's mine. I might get broke, my money might funny, and my chain might get strange, but God gave it to me. God will provide a way for me to keep what God done gave me. I've been sick, sick as I could be. Didn't think I was gonna make it. The doctor said one thing, but look at God, I'm still standing. Is that your story? You've been through the storms and the rain. You've seen the lightning flash. You heard the thunders roll. You felt the sin dashes trying to conquer your soul. But can you hear Paul saying, though they slay me, yet will I trust in the Lord? I gotta go, y'all. But before I get out of here, I wanna tell you this. I was a long shot, but I won with God. They wrote me off, but God wrote me in. They said I wouldn't, but God said I would. And God is with me. He reminds me every day that I live.
I brought you this far. It wasn't easy. Keep on fighting. Keep on going. Put that cross on your shoulder. Quit crying like a crybaby. Like you ain't got no hope. Wipe your eyes. Gird your loins. Get up. Get up. Get up. Get up. And tell it. Tell it. I come this far by faith. Yeah. I was a long shot, but I won with God. Yeah. 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 You looking at a long shot. You say, I ain't never seen one? Look at me. Here is a long shot in the flesh. They said as a pastor I wouldn't make it. Look at me now, y'all. They say you don't know how to preach. That was a... They said he never sang. They said when I was in the employment world, he can't keep a job. As long as Franklin come by, I can keep a job. When Franklin quit making it to the bank, you sure right, I ain't gonna stay on that job. Y'all will catch that on the way home. God is my way maker. My burden sharer. My heart fixer and my mind regulator. And since I know what I know, y'all can't tell me what God can't do, because I'm standing as an example of what a long shot is. That sermon came from me talking to one of my mentees this week, and they were talking about what they did not have, and they wasn't sure what this was going to turn out to be. It happened twice. Hold up, Bro Willis. It happened twice. And I told him, I said, as good as God been to you, as many odds as you done beat, how can you tell me you don't think it's gonna work? Because what you have now, by man's standard, you shouldn't have had. But by God's standard, you have it. And I got to say that twice this week. And I told him, you was a long shot, but you won with God. And God began to speak to me, Reverend Henry. He said, boy, you a long shot, and you just don't realize why I took you through what you went through so that you can encourage others when they go through. That's why I'm not ashamed to tell my story. I am a long shot, but I have won with God. And I want you to remember this, regardless.
regardless of what you go through, keep looking up toward the hills from whence cometh your help, and you declare, my help cometh from the Lord. And when you declare that, just deal with what you got to deal with and watch God work that thing out. And when God worked that thing out, can't nobody do nothing for you. One of the thrills I get is working on old cars. And people buy this car and that car. I like old cars. But whatever car I get, I don't want it to look like yours. And I enjoy people telling me what can't be done. And a guy asked me the other day, he said, where does all this creativity come from? I said, it comes from not wanting to be like nobody else. And Friday, my head was bad. I got in one of my cars and let the top down and went to the hangout spot. And the thrill of that keeps me going, people are running them video cameras, taking a picture of the car, not knowing it was mine. I stood within range where I could hear. And they were saying, who built it? It's nice. Ain't seen nothing like that. I'm still standing back. I ain't never moved. Finally, one guy came up and said, it's the preacher's. And he pointed where I was standing. And he said, is this yours? I said, it is. Y'all catch what I said, the part I cleaned up. It wasn't one of us. Somebody else of another persuasion who had trouble embracing the reality that a person of my complexion could have a masterpiece like that. I was a long shot, but I won with God. That's my story. So don't let nobody get in your head. Everybody in here is long shots. If you think about it and be honest with yourself, people wrote you off. They wrote you off. You might not nod your head while you're in here because you don't know who's looking. Just be honest with yourself. And if you know what I'm saying is true, just give God some praise. God bless you. I pray that the message has been a help to somebody on this second Sunday, that it reminds you that even though you are a long shot, you're going to win with God.
Looking for some inspirational gospel content? Just subscribe to Brother Rollins' YouTube channel today. We post the most motivational and preaching videos and gospel songs that are sure to get you through any situation. Even better, we have also launched a new apparel store that gives you access to a wide range of high-quality items. From awesome tees to hoodies, sweatshirts, mugs, and even tote bags, you can now proclaim your faith wherever you go and support our YouTube channel. Just visit the Brother Rollins YouTube channel and click on the store tab to shop now.